Several major defeats in the spring and summer of 1942 were followed by yet further difficult battles at Stalingrad and Caucasus. It seemed the area of Novorossiysk and the Caucasus coastline were fated to fall to the enemy. A sudden USSR counterstrike rolled in like thunder along the Volga River. The steel claws of the mechanized corps gouged deeply into the flanks of the army of General Paulus. The Black Sea Fleet and the 18th Army received orders from General Headquarters to assume the offensive. Yuzhnaya Ozeraika is a small but strategically important village southwest of Novorossiysk. On the night of February 4th, 1943, a Soviet assault force was sent there to attack the rear flanks of the German forces guarding the village. For the first time in the Black Sea area, a tank battalion was included in the operation to help make the initial strike more powerful. Single, well-placed attack of Marines, ships, and tanks, Soviet command was hoping to crush the Allied German-Romanian coastal defenses and deal a powerful blow to the rear forces guarding this strategic center.
Come on! Mines ahead. We won't be able to get through. Let's try to get around the hill to the right, flank the Germans. Germans have abandoned their positions. They're retreating to the village. The right flank is regrouping. Damn! They've regrouped their right flank. We have to make the battery on this hill our top priority, or we'll be in big trouble.
Нет! И готовится! Ivan!
Стрелять по команде!
Слышно, товарищ командир? Да точно! Вижу врага! Так точно!
Even the veterans who had participated in the landing in Feodosia admitted that it was a very difficult battle. Heavy fire from enemy artillery and mortars resulted in severe casualties even before the landing began. The majority of Stuart tanks of the 563rd Tank Battalion didn't even make it to the shore. But those Marines who had landed fought fiercely and stood their ground firmly, maintaining battle formation. And although the bulk of the force failed to land and retreated to the east, several hundred Red Army soldiers and a handful of Stuart tanks nevertheless managed to complete their battle objectives and secure Yuzhnaya Ozarayka village.